emerging from a cocoon into a caterpillar, from a caterpillar to a butterfly. The metamorphosis is here, it's live. Metamorphosis.
Metamorphosis, word, sound, and power, music, drumming, current affairs, everything to grow and lift up your mind. Metamorphosis.
Metamorphosis, creating beauty and stimulating change from a constant supply of relevant knowledge and information.
No more youths and youths for sale. We get wise and don't decide to change their style. Bobby Rock, keep your empty promises and your crooked smile. Metamorphosis, come with your thoughts. Change your way of thinking. Metamorphosis. The change begins with you.
Black men of Carthage, black men of Ethiopia, Timbuktu, Alexandria gave the light of civilization to this world. Ethiopia shall stretch forth our hands unto God, and princes shall come out of Egypt.
I am I, son of the Most High, Jah Rastafari.
Keep listening.
Hey, diggle, diggle. The white man a giggle. Oh, black people are struggle to get into the kingdom of heaven.
Take Jah again.
If you really love Jah, oh, seek him for yourself. And don't seek man. Flesh will feel it, yeah.
You know,
supply here, you son of slave out yourself.
Them don't give a heck about us. Them don't give a heck about us. All them sit down in the parliament every day and a talk. Them don't give a heck about us. Mr. Government, don't give a heck about us. Them don't give a heck about us. All the pastors, they pop up with every Sunday and I preach. Them don't give a heck about us.
How we feel the pain. Capital gain, we can't get visa every day. Them take plane like taxes, and happy with tax happy pay. For every mistake and every game where you play, you waste the money, go buy out a many and left one people in a tax jeopardy. You split the motor, you're so selfish. I like how you give a 3,000 acres to China. The road's accessible and all, it's really nice. It put people on a level, make it seem like we are rise. But why you want people to pay up here the price? The people ask, answer if you hear the voice. We are cry out every day, Shelly can't take it. Pressure on a church, we go pray. Before pastor pray, he might try make a way. If you see if him can get little Shelly might cheer. He said them don't give a heck about us. Parliament every day and attack them. Don't give a heck about us, Mr. Government. Don't give a heck about us. Them don't give a heck about us. All the pastors they pump up with every Sunday and I preach. Them don't give a heck about us. Granny light cut off, can't pay water rate. Take your last dollar dash in a collection plate. Papa died as a papa. Granny a try hold the faith while the pastor live in a estate. Politician and pastor equal to poverty. Listen to me keenly, me talking to everybody. Them capital gain off of them first priority. Tear down we house, we are squat on them property. Race and religion equal to hypocrisy. Organize and centralize, seek your democracy. Entrepreneurship and me philosophy. Every man to them one thing, oh what a synergy. Open up your eyes, read between the lines. Look how much them sell out and the dollar still a slide. They say there's nothing they can do, but that's a lie. You leave the people hungry
society. Police kick off the youth door and go kill him, and when they
goes away from Africa with the intention to steal our culture, the good for the past by instead. Humble yourself, my children. Humble yourself, my little ones. Humble yourself. Oh, my brother, you.
People perish in Nepal. What are we doing in Jamaica? Nepal. Reality check. Act of God. Nepal. God, the author of destruction. Nepal, reality, life, death. Tenastelin, greetings, hail unto the ones and ones listening to the Metamorphosis. Urgently moving into what is pressing. Disaster in civilization. The earthquake that has brought Nepal to its knees, showing you the power of the earth. Sometimes these quakes are man-made, manufactured by man himself. Sometimes these quakes are natural. And in the naturality of these quakes, thousands and thousands die. So it makes I and I begin to really contemplate, what is this thing now that is called death? That is ever so prominent, yet within the mythology of Christianity, it is the greatest fear. We're seeing plenty of it. We're going to, I and I, within this metamorphosis, explore really what is this phenomenon called death. Is it the opposite of life? Or does life really have an opposite? If life is energy, eternal. So with this thing that surrounds us, that we have been trained to think that it is a point that everybody must get to, rich, poor, or no matter class, creed, or gender. It therefore kind of forced I and I to re-examine, what is this phenomenon? Is a mango dead after it falls off a tree? Is it dead because it has been cut off from its source of nutrients? And if not, what then is the power of the seed? So within the metamorphosis, we're going to really explore this whole thing that have much of Christendom locked up in this notion of death and the afterlife. I realize that these concepts have been within civilizations long before Christianity and long before Muslim, long before Islam. The ancient Africans had their notion of the afterlife. So it seems as though the phenomenon, this death that is, for example, that has hit the people in Nepal in such a vast number, opens the door to questions such as the cause. And if this cause is divine, then death seems to be something that this divine things force gets great amount of fun out of, because there's much disaster natural. Whenever these disasters occur, it is usually noted that these are acts of God. And so these acts of destruction, tornadoes and hurricanes and tsunamis, conjures up the image of a God that is very violent. And therefore, death now would appear to be a normal activity within the tradition. So what I put in out more before we get into the essence, the one who wants them think about this duality that we have been given to think about, that life and death are opposites. And I am proposing that they are not opposites. But the opposite of death, rather than being life, is really birth. And so birth and death, now we're going to look at birth and death as points in the cycle of life. And begin to explore what really then is this notion of death. Realizing also that we do engage in sleep. And that we move between sleep and wake. And what is a great difference then between sleep and death? So much of Black world has been locked into this fear, created through violence, of course, and brutality, and the whole notion of the black man having something that he must save, which is this concept now called the soul. So we're given all these things in two books and literature. And so that takes on a significant difference now in Christendom, to the point wherein it is the only way into the kingdom of heaven. You have to go through death. And at the same time, the most important aspect of what we call creation is life. So African people are caught between celebrating life and celebrating death, because of the notion of death being something that will liberate an aspect of the self that is what you need to save. So we're going to look into these things throughout the metamorphosis. The source of evil, for example. What is the source of evil? We see violence overtaking the societies. And is violence a source of, is violence evil? Then we want to also tap into what is the source of all evil. It is something spiritual, or is the source of all evil within the meditation of the human beings themselves. Because it is important now that we begin to really recognize the source of good. What is evil? Is there something that is invisible in the sky or under the ground responsible for all evil? Or does evil come out of the thinking of men? And if so, how do we deal with men who think evil? Do we leave them for some judgment in some life to come? Or do we deal with them in the present? Black people, African people, people in Christendom need to take a look at this phenomenon that we fear, but we are conscious of its inevitability. Metamorphosis.
Travel up the old rough road to find my dream, to find my dream. Call so loud, search all around. No one could hear my cry, but in my attitude, they call me now creation, rebel. To my waist, yes. My shirt and my back. It's gone, it's gone. Feeling my attitude, yes. They call me now creation. Brave enough.
Just before I and I get into the fullness now, I want to give thanks for the event that took place in the Neville Antonio Park last week, Sunday. Rastakura and the army of poets and word sound practitioners gathered in the park in Port Antonio and released some powerful energies that brought culture and consciousness into the same space, and economics, marketing, buying and selling of cultural items. It was a excellent presentation and organization Very, very calm. No bangarang and boisterousness. Nice African women there. Whole heap of princesses and queens. And must say why it's harder and harder and harder for black man be monogamous. It is so hard. Hey, boy, may I tell you. And we're in this Western straight jacket. And the women know, say, we're having a hard time, you know. And them now make it no easier. Them was coming out nicer. And them was outdo one another. And I look better and better and better. And man just get more and more mixed up. But it was very nice. And the thing about it now, Muta Baruka was the main host for the program. And some other well-known artists came through DYCR. They were local presenters. And something that is needed. Thing about it now is that sometimes the general population don't want to spend their income money to come into these events. They want the knowledge, they want the energy, but them tend to want it kind of free. We need to invest in our own selves and spend amongst ourselves and build economics amongst ourselves. So it's a great thing, and hopefully it can happen again. You know, Agro World Fest. That was the fifth one. And it was in the Port Antonio art, you know. Another important part of the thing was about seeds. In that there was an effort now to raise the consciousness of the people about these GMO seeds, genetically modified seeds that are being made by this great company in America. And they want to control agriculture. That means they have to control the plantings. Then we certainly shall be hungry forever. And so the seed now becomes a foundation to your economy and your culture. And when I talk about the real extent of a seed, it is really the starting of our life forms. When we talk about it, into the whole of the earth setup. Nearly all things come from a seed. And so when we think about the history of the earth and life forms and birth and death and reproduction, it's hard to do all those things without a seed. So when we explore now even things like death, we have to also look at the power now that is really birth, the seed. And I man proposed earlier that we're not going to look at life as the opposite of death. We're going to look at birth, and that birth and death occur within life. So there should be no misunderstanding as to what the language is all about. So this birth process, which is foundation now, the seed become critical. And if you look at the earth, the planet, the trees, the animals, those things generate seeds. So reproduction through seeds is an important science. And the planet itself now, when you begin to look at the history of the planet and talk about life now cannot be just looked at as at the human form, because there's life at the animal kingdom, there's life at the plant kingdom, there's life at the biological level of plants and algae. So when we talk about death in any format, we have to explore what life is in a broader construct. And we have to look into now the things that have life outside of just man. And these things that have life also experience birth and death as a part of the cycle within life. The foundation now to this life and the seeds is really, when you look at it, you know, plant life, seeds, fish, seed, trees, seed, man, seed. So the planet now, at a cosmic level, had to be seeded at some point in its geological past. The planet had to be seeded for life to take form. And you look at the planet now and its anciency. The ocean, becomes a site now for early forms of what we know as life. And we'll go into the